There has been a sharp difference between the reportage of the international media and Indian media on Kashmir since the government revoked Article 370 on 5th August. While the international media showed protests in Kashmir, the Indian media stressed on normalcy. On Friday, 9th August, Reuters, BBC and Al Jazeera reported that a massive protest took place at Saura in Srinagar and that the security forces fired on the protesters. No Indian channel covered this protest. Republic's Arnab Goswami called it fake news.
If it was fake news, a lie, a dirty and motivated lie by a dying government-owned British channel, then I want to know, and India wants to know, what is your intention, BBC?
The international media has brought out several troubling details from Kashmir, which Indian channels have largely ignored. For instance, Time magazine and New York Times reported that over 2,000 people have been detained in Kashmir. But Times now labelled many of the detainees as terrorists. UK-based newspaper The Independent reported that authorities are refusing to give death certificates for those killed in clashes with security forces. But no Indian TV channel took up the story. American magazine Foreign Policy reported that security personnel forced Kashmiri civilians to chant Vande Mataram. On the other hand, India TV said that Jawans are working to keep Kashmir safe. Reuters reported on the difficulties faced by local Kashmiri reporters, but Open Magazine's Rahul Pandita ridiculed them and said that if journalists cannot find 5 minutes of internet every day, then they don't deserve to be journalists. BBC and AP even captured on camera security forces taking away a doctor just after he complained of a shortage of medicines. No Indian channel covered this story. But there is news that foreign media did not report on the killing of truck driver Noor Muhammad Dar by a mob and a murder of two Gujar men allegedly by militants. These were widely covered in Indian media. Sections of the Indian media also gave misleading information on several occasions. ANI presented a mosque in Jammu as Eid prayers in Srinagar. Several publications carried ANI's videos and photos without verifying them. Many channels also showed a few Kashmiris interacting with NSA Ajit Doval in South Kashmir, suggesting that they had no ill will towards the PM's key advisor. But other media outlets pointed out that these people didn't know who Ajit Doval was at that time. A few journalists presented one Muhammad Ashraf Azad as a Kashmiri supporting the government on Article 370, but they forgot to mention that he's a BJP leader. By failing to report several aspects of the Kashmir crisis, perhaps many channels are following the Press Council of India chairman's mantra, some news is best not reported.